Picture this scenario. You're a business analyst and your boss walks in the room and says, show me customers who spent over $500 since the start of the year, sorted by how much they spent. The data is sitting right there in your customer's database with the names, the date, and the total amount spent by these customers. You know exactly what you're looking for. Now, sure, you might have some dashboards that can get you close to this answer if they've already been made, or if there's an easy way to grab that data, maybe through an Excel file or some other option. But the moment that you need something different, maybe a different date range, or you want to combine this customer's data with another table, you need to use SQL. This is SQL, Structured Query Language, one of the most widely used programming languages in the world. If you work with data in any capacity, you're probably interacting with SQL whether you know it or not. But here's the thing. Even this relatively straightforward query requires knowing specific SQL syntax. So let's walk through what this actually says. Select name and total spent from the customers table, which is name and total spent from customers, where the date is greater than January 1st, 2025. So that's from this year. And the total amount spent is greater than 500. So that's only going to grab rows with the total amount spent over $500. And finally, order by the total spent descending, so in descending order, with the highest amount first. Every piece has to be exactly right. You can't say, show me name and total spent, or since January 1st, 2025, instead of this specific format. This is the fundamental gap that most organizations face. The people who best understand the business questions are not necessarily the people who can write the complex database queries. And the people who can write the SQL aren't always available when you need that urgent analysis. For decades, this meant either learning SQL by yourself, waiting for a data analyst, or settling for what your existing BI tools can provide. But large language models, the same AI technology we're seeing power generation tasks and other use cases, have completely changed this equation. LLM-based text-to-SQL is the process of taking a user's natural language question, running it through an LLM, generating a SQL query, and then executing that query on a database, ultimately resulting in data coming back to the user. The concept seems straightforward, but this has been a challenge that, prior to LLMs, was extremely difficult to solve reliably. So here's how modern AI systems actually make this work. To understand the process, let me walk through an example that illustrates the key steps. And we'll use movies because who doesn't love movies? So imagine you have a movie database, like IMDb, and someone asks what movies were directed by Christopher Nolan. So let's break down how text-to-SQL can help with this question. We'll do this in two parts. So part one is schema understanding. The AI needs to understand what our database looks like. We can solve this problem by providing the LLM, the database schema, which is the structure of your tables and columns. Things like director name, rating, or maybe the box office and how it did on the opening weekend. The AI needs to understand this because it needs to learn your technical structure of the database that it's using. However, modern systems need to go further than just understanding the director name or ratings or box office. They also need to understand your business context. In your movie database, if someone asks for recent movies, the LLM needs to know that recent movies in your database means released in the last 2 years, or that top rated or ratings refers to movies with an IMDb rating above an 8. Also, systems learn from successful past queries. So for example, if I've previously asked what sci-fi movies do I have in my database, and the system generates the right SQL, it can remember that pattern for future genre-based questions. So our LLM combines our schema understanding and structural knowledge of our personal movie collection, as well as how it's broken down based on business context and past queries, to help it understand how you think and organize your movies. Part two is content linking. Real-world databases are messy. That director's name might be stored as Chris Nolan, could be stored as C. Nolan, or it could be stored as Nolan, comma, Chris. There's a million different ways you can enter someone's name. And so the AI needs to handle this through what we call semantic matching. The system doesn't just look for exact matches to Christopher Nolan. It understands that all three of these variations refer to the same person and can generate the sequel that helps find them all. This works because the AI can analyze your actual database content and create what's called vector representation. This is essentially a mathematical fingerprint of each piece of data. And so similar names like Chris Nolan, C. Nolan, Nolan Chris, as well as Christopher Nolan, how we all know him, can get the similar fingerprint so the AI can recognize those variations automatically. The same principle applies to your business data. Product names, customer categories, department names, any field where the entry isn't perfect or standardized over time can value from content linking. So between schema understanding and content linking, modern AI systems can handle both the structure and the messiness of real databases, representing major breakthroughs that makes text-to-SQL practical. Now, this technology is impressive, but we need to be realistic about where we are. There are performance benchmarks. One of the most popular is called BERD, that test LLM-based SQL systems against messy, real-world databases, instead of cleaned-up academic datasets typically used in research. The results reveal where current systems still struggle. So first is with scale and performance. Academic datasets are small and controlled, but production databases can have thousands of tables and millions of rows. Generating efficient SQL that runs quickly on these massive datasets requires optimization skills that current AI systems are still developing. The second is edge cases and unusual data patterns. Real-world databases contain unexpected relationships, legacy data structures, and unique business scenarios that when systems encounter these edge cases, they can produce SQL that doesn't have the correct syntax or returns incorrect values. However, the systems that work best today are rapidly improving, and they're combining robust schema understanding as well as content linking with better optimization techniques and domain-specific training. LLM-based text-to-SQL represents a fundamental shift from requiring SQL expertise to enabling natural language data exploration. The technology isn't perfect yet, but is very practical for common questions, and it's already changing how organizations access data. So next time your boss walks in asking for those customer insights, or you want to find out all about Christopher Nolan movies, the barrier between you and answering that question is finally starting to disappear.